Tennessee and Gonzaga meeting for the second time this season. This one was scheduled. The first one in Orlando. What was the result of getting to the end of the tournament? Hey, how are you folks? Jason Horowitz. Glad to be with you here on CBSSports.com. Of course, talking about a tournament that took place over Thanksgiving when Tennessee lost to Gonzaga. Gary Parrish was there for that one. He'll be there in Tennessee for this one. And let's bring him in right now on the phone to break it down. And Gary, when you and I first sat down and chatted about this game, first thing that came out of your mouth was, I bet both coaches wish at this point that they wouldn't have scheduled this game.
Yeah, I mean, I spent about 30 minutes on the phone with Mark Few last night, and he is, you know, by his own admission, kicking himself a little bit for putting his team through this schedule. Look, he does believe that if A.J. Price's, you know, awkward three-pointer in that Connecticut game a few weeks ago doesn't fall to force overtime, then they don't lose the next one against Portland State and the next one against Utah. He said that that shot, not necessarily the loss, but the way the loss happened has really affected the mindset of his team. They've lost confidence, they've lost their swagger, and now they've lost three straight, and heading to Tennessee where even if you're playing well, you're probably supposed to lose that game. And he loses that one, then they go to 8-5. So, you know, this is not ideal for the Zags. A, to have to be playing a team like Tennessee on the road right now. B, to have to travel back to the Eastern time zone for the third time this season. On the other side, Bruce Pearl coming off a loss at Kansas. They've already got three losses at Temple. To Gonzaga in Orlando and then at Kansas over the weekend. Now they've got a team that was ranked in the preseason top 10 they've got to play, or else they've got their fourth loss. So this isn't ideal for anybody, but they'll play the game and it should be fun.
Well, you're breaking down what's wrong with both these teams, and of course it starts with scheduling, but they're losing some of these games here, Gary, both these teams. Let's go back to Gonzaga for a sec. When you look at this team, because we were so high on them 3-4 weeks ago as a nation, is there something wrong with Mark Few's team?
Yeah, I mean, I think a lot of it is just swagger. I mean, I peppered Mark about this last night, and he said a lot of it's confidence. Now, in fairness, the UConn game, now the Arizona loss at Arizona, that was just a loss. They just lost the game. So let's go ahead and chalk that one up. The UConn game, if A.J. Price, again, you know, they miss a three, Connecticut does in the final 10 seconds, get the rebound, Price gets it, hits like a double pump, weird, awkward three-pointer over Pargo to force overtime, UConn wins. That ball doesn't fall, and 9 times out of 10 it probably doesn't. They win that game. Then they got Portland State at home, and rather than be totally drained by a ridiculous loss in Seattle and then having to play, you know, a team like Portland State 2 days before Christmas, they probably come out a little fresher, come out a little more focused and win that game. Instead, they screw it up, lose that game. And then the one at Utah is just, you know, they're in the middle of a downward spiral. So I think, you know, and Mark Few believes this more importantly, you take that one shot, and their season has turned on this one A.J. Price three-pointer. But he, some of the basic basketball stuff isn't there. They're not making shots the way they were. They're not necessarily guarding the way they were. They're not rebounding the way they were. But more than anything, he pinpoints just a loss of a swagger and a loss of confidence and a little bit of loss of focus that has resulted in this downward spiral. And, you know, and my thing to him was, you know, Thompson Bowling Arena in Knoxville in front of 22,000 people singing Rocky Top isn't necessarily the place try to go get refocused and get back on track.
No, but they have a chance because Tennessee's coming off a loss as well, and maybe they'll be drained from that game at Kansas over the weekend. When you look at this one, Gary, what's going to be the key to this game? You've already seen these teams play once already this year. What will be the key to the rematch?
Well, the last time they played, Tennessee dominated on the boards, but Gonzaga, they played with confidence, a different swagger. And even Mark Few last night said, you know, we're not the same team as Tennessee saw. You know, we don't walk into the gym the same way. We don't go through the layup line the same way. We don't have that same sort of confidence that they had at the time. And so the key will be, you know, what Gonzaga team comes out. Is it the team that, you know, rolled Maryland in Orlando and then beat Tennessee by 9 points? Or is it the team that just lost it, strung losses to Portland State and Utah? Either way, even if they're at their best, it's going to be hard to win in Knoxville. That's not a place many people go and win. You know, Tennessee, despite the losses, is still the SEC favorite, still going to have 22,000 people there. So that's the biggest problem for Gonzaga, is that even if they play well, they still might lose, and then their confidence still sinks lower. Again, just not an ideal spot to be playing this game.
Nope, should be a very tough one for Gonzaga. We'll see how it all plays out Wednesday night. And, Gary, you'll be there, and we'll read all your stuff on CBSSports.com when it's done. Thank you very much, sir.
Thanks,
all right, folks, for more on this game or any other here this week, be sure to stay with CBSSports.com. I'm Jason Horowitz for Gary Parrish. Take care, folks.